Hello everyone, namaskar, how are you all? I hope you are fine. So let's solve one more question from differential equation, the partial differential equation. So this time we have another question from nonlinear partial differential equation. So let's see how to solve questions like this. The first thing which you will notice that this is a function in terms of zpq. Okay, so if I want to write this for you to understand, so I can write this as q square minus z square p square 1 minus p square equals to 0. So this is clearly a function of zpq. Which is second standard form. So whenever we get a question from second standard form, how do we solve that? We just take an substitution which is x capital X equal to small x plus ay. Okay, and now we try to find the value of p and q in terms of this capital X. So p is del z by del x, but now z is function of, we are considering z as function of capital X only. Earlier it was function of x and y, so we used to write del z by del x, but now we will be writing del z by del capital X. And because x is further capital X is further a function of x and y, so let's this time partially differentiate it with respect to small x. Okay, so I have just done one thing, multiplied and divide by del x and del x. Okay, so now the value of this value we can find from the above equation. So if you want to find, you can find del capital X by del small x, that will come out to be 1, and also del capital X by del small y, that will come out to be a. I'm just differentiating partially, so when partially differentiating with respect to x, ay is constant, so its derivative is 0. When partially differentiating with respect to y, small x is constant. So here I can write my p as, now because z is only function of x, I can write instead of del, I can write d, so dz by dx, okay, into 1. So this is my p. And what about my q? My q is a times dz by dx. How? If you want, if you think I have skipped, I haven't skipped this, q is del z by del x, but now z is a function of capital X. Capital X is further a function of x and y, so this time I am partially differentiating it with respect to y, so del x by del y. Now this del x by del y I found came out to be a, and because z is a function of x only, so I can replace this by dz by dx, so my q is this, a dz by dx. So I have found the value of p and q, put that in the question. So I will get q, I will replace by a dz by dx, so this will become a square dz by dx whole square equals to z square p square. So dz by dx whole square, and 1 minus again p square, so dz by dx whole square. Fine. Now I can take this term inside in the RHS, so I will get a square dz by dx whole square equals to z square multiplied by 1, so z square dz by dx whole square minus z square dz by dx power 4. I can cancel dz by dx square from both sides, so I will get a square, I have not written that step, equals to z square 1 minus dz by dx whole square. I came back to step number 1 only, just I can say dz by dx from both sides. Now what I can do, I have this, so let's do one thing, a square by z square equals to 1 minus dz by dx whole square. Send dz by dx to other side, equals to 1 minus a square by z square, so that can be written as z square minus a square divided by z square. If I take square root on both sides, I will get dz by dx again. I think I have done that mistake which I am known to do. I haven't written d capital X everywhere starting from here, this step, so everywhere it will be capital X only. So everywhere it will be capital X in denominator. Okay. So dz by dx on taking square root, dz by dx will be equal to z minus a square under the root divided by z. So z dz I think everything is fine, I am not missing anything. So z dz equals to under root z square minus a square dx. I am taking this under root z square minus a square down in the LHS. So as I can see, if I take denominator as t, always better to take denominator inside, whatever is inside the root, as t square. So if you take this as t square, z square minus a square as t square, differentiate both sides, so we'll get 2z dz equals to 2t dt. Two and two gets cancelled, so z dz equals to t dt. So z dz, if I integrate both sides in this step only, so in place of z dz I can put t dt and divided by root. And inside root I have t square, so I will get t integration equals to integration of x dx is x plus a constant c. This t gets cancelled. Integration of dt is nothing but t, and what was my t? That will be under root of z square minus a square equals to, what was my x? My x, as you can see, is small x plus ay. As you can see, the lag is again prominent when it comes to a digital board. So that's the one thing which I don't like about digital board. When writing on whiteboard, you can have your flow, the flow is better. Here sometimes the lagging is there, which makes flow very very bad. So x plus ay plus c, okay. Now squaring both sides, so if I don't use any bracket here, so if I square both sides, I will get z square minus a square is equal to x plus ay plus c the whole square. And further, finally, I can write z square equals to a square plus x plus ay plus c the whole square. So this is my final answer, z square equals to a square plus x plus ay plus c whole square. Final simplification is all your choice. Now how I solved, I first saw that this is a function of ztq, so this is a question of nonlinear partial differential equation, second standard form. What we do in that, capital X is small x plus ay, we find p and q. Because z is now completely a function of capital X, so replace del by d. So you got the value of p and q, put that back in the first equation. Okay, solve it. This is just a question of variable separable form in normal ODE world, which you have done a lot of question right from standard 12th. So that's it. It was an easy one at the end. I hope you enjoyed it. Do watch my partial differential equation playlist where I discussed question right from the beginning, from formation of partial differential equation, and all this type of questions. You will get a lot of this type of question there. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks and have a nice day.